This is a very short video about a bistable. This is a bistable. I built it earlier using a 4043 chip. It has two inputs. The yellow button is called the set, and the red button is called the reset. It has one output, which is the LED. On my oscilloscope display, the red LED is represented by the red line, and at the moment it's reading zero, it's off. On my oscilloscope, the blue line represents the set input, and at the moment it is also reading zero, it's off. If I press the set, let's see what happens. It comes on, and the output comes on, as we can see. If I let the set go, it goes off, but the output stays on. The output remains on even though I've let go of the set. If I press the set button several more times, it doesn't make any difference to the output. The output stays on. To turn the output off, I need to press the reset. There it goes. If I press the reset many more times, nothing happens. I only have to press the set very momentarily, but the output will stay on for pretty well ever, or until the battery runs out, or until I press the reset. But something interesting to see though, this wire here is the enable. At the moment it's connected to positive and the chip is working. If I disconnect the enable and leave it unconnected, then I don't know what's going to happen, all sorts of strange things. But if I connect the enable to ground like that, now the set and the reset don't do anything. The chip has been disabled. To make the chip work, the enable has to be connected to positive. Let's reconnect it. And reset the chip. And then we wait for the oscilloscope. We press the set. And the output will now stay on forever, or until the battery goes flat. See, it just stays on. And on. And on.